Yo, what's up? The name is Jet Leowana. It's game time. Let's play something. Yo, what's up? The name is Jet Leowana. Welcome back to more Torchlight. And I did some research and I found out that I was completely wrong. What I said last episode of the ending, that the next tile set is the last one. I found out that that is not true. We have a good way to go yet. So if you were kind of getting disappointed that I was almost done with this, which I doubt you were, but hey, if you were, there's more to come. A lot more to come. Because Ordrak is until a long way down. Did I say Ordrak? Oops, I didn't mean to say Ordrak. Ordrak is nothing. Just forget it. Forget I mentioned anything. Okay, now we get to read another of Alric's journal as soon as the epic loading screen is gone. Alric's journal, right there, as soon as I mentioned it.
From within.
So the dwarves got attacked by Ordrak,
and his essence flowed through the ember,
and then they got poisoned by the ember. So apparently the corruption we have is from Ordrak. That explains things.
But my understanding comes from the ember.
So there's remains from the battle.
He speaks to me through the veins, and I cannot.
And Ordrak cannot leave the bottom of the dungeon where the most power of the ember is.
Ordrak cannot leave the source of his immortality.
So he thinks he could change the world if he released Ordrak. Yeah, he's losing his mind, and whoa, was that like an automatic door? Oh, this is the most awesome tile set ever. I never made it this far, but this is awesome. It's all technological. It's a keg. Hey, look, robot. Oh, dwarven white. I thought it was a robot. It's not. It's zombified dwarves. Holy crap, chain gun. Run away, it explodes. Oh, it doesn't explode. Ember Thrall. Zombies! This is Left 4 Dead now. Great. Steel's men, I cannot be interrupted. Scale Brim. Okay, so Dovahkiin's gonna have a hard time here. Even though it's not level scaled like Hatch's quests. This is a very impressive tile set. It actually apparently has a lot of options. And no, not those again. Spectres, right? Spectres are back. And not the cool kind, like Shepard. Watcher Geist. Resurrects the dwarf in white. I'm just going to spam heavy attack because it works. A lot of enemies everywhere. This is like, I don't even know what to compare it to. It's like saying, like, this tile set now is more Call of Duty compared to, I don't know, like Fallout 2 for the other ones. I didn't play much Fallout 2 mostly because I herp derped and waste half of the time that they allot you at the beginning to do whatever, trying to figure out how to get into towns. I like walked around the town apparently for like a month because I didn't know how to have the characters enter the city.
A trap has been sprung.
I let my friend play it though, and he said it was very enjoyable. And I really want to figure out how to play Fallout 2 just so I can get Goris. Deathclaw party member, heck yeah. I think he's even an albino one too, so that makes him even more important because the albino ones are stronger than normal Deathclaws. I don't get that. Why is that in Fallout that if it's albino, it gets an attack bonus? I don't know. I guess that's just their easy way to make it so people can recognize, hey, this guy's tougher. But they also have giant ones, so that stops making sense. It's like, hey, you could just make this one a giant one if you wanted to make it more dangerous. Like, they already have the system there, but they count albino and giant as an entirely different class of being. Like, albino rad scorpion has different stats to the giant rad scorpion, I believe. I don't know. Why am I talking about an unrelated game that I'm not playing? I'm playing this game. Chain gun attack. Resists poison and fire. Deathwalker Battlemaster. What the heck? Let me get a look at him. Those skull textures are actually pretty good on the skeleton there. Oh, his body disappeared. Great. He fell through the wall. I don't think he was supposed to fall through the wall. Shrine of Enchantment. I'm running into a lot of these now in the game. I ran into one on the last extras.
Fortune is kind to you.
Wait, 316, yeah. It didn't increase the damage that time. That's disappointing. Ballista? I wonder what this does. Ooh, wow, that's a lot of damage. Come at me, come at me, come on. Mess. Like combo attack him. What is going on here? And that's a short attack. Chain gun. Charging into battle. It's like Call of Duty. I was right.
Go, go, go.
Flea. The run gun flea got high. Go. Oh. I forget these aren't level scaled. They're like nothing compared to me. Especially compared to Hatch's Quest. I survived Hatch's Quest. I can survive whatever the main dungeon throws at me. Unless I do something incredibly stupid. That or they bring back people with explosive arrows. Those explosive arrows were horrible to fight. It's like, you cannot go in this area. You cannot go in this area either. Or this area, because I said so. Derp a derp. I keep being ignored. I have my thing set to busy. I have my title changed to working on Let's Play. Why can't anyone understand that this means don't talk? Oh well. I forgive you, they're my friend. That's actually a pretty neat death animation there. They just fall over. Slightly hilarious. Now what did this ballista do other than completely kill everyone in there? It didn't kill everybody. Deathwalker battle. Oh snap, that's scary. He's like half ember. Now why are we curing ourselves of that again? Yeah, it actually is pretty cool. I would love a power boost like that, plus the transformation. Can we get an amberfied reskin? There's a guy stuck in the corner there.
A trap has been sprung.
See though, I don't think he's trapped in the corner. But I'm a sniper. Gotcha. Okay, I leveled up, so what should I put points into this time? Oh, I unlocked the level 20 thing. Yeah, I already knew I had the level 20 thing because I have block and parry in there. So I'm going to put points into block and parry, and then next level up I'm going to put my points into block and parry. So then, thanks to block and parry, I will have a 1 in 10 chance to block every attack that comes my way. And that's awesome. Soulless Cutter. Seen that actually. So glad I did this let's play, because now I get to see things on the game that I never really did. Voltron. That's exactly one letter away from Voltron. Wow. I'm pretty sure that's due to the randomizer mod. Name randomizer. Yeah. So I say, it's like you might want to get out of the way if I'm going to be shooting that. My character's smart though, sometimes. He actually figured out what would happen if he stood in the way of a giant ballista firing at him. What just happened? Freezing axe. What is that above everybody? Oh right, that red guy can enrage the little ones. Hey, you leave my dog alone. This is not going to end up like Old Yeller. Wait, it wouldn't end up like Old Yeller anyways. The kid had to kill him. Oops, sorry. Oh, the ballista's broken. Or did I already use it? It's an identify scroll. I don't need identify scrolls, but they're good to sell. Is that another champion already? That's another champion already. That's a mage champion. Oh, it's an overseer.
My pack is full.
No. You do not bully my pack.
My pack is full.
Okay, inventory management. Rune blade. It's a pretty poor rune blade there. Hold up. There we go. No, 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 no. I don't even use shields. No. 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 That was a pretty poor haul there. Tribal Scutum. I don't even know. Not gonna step in the trap. I stepped on the trap. Like an idiot. I even heard it go off. It made like a noise. Although I suppose that's to be expected, considering I just said I heard it go off. I don't know, but it's amazing how good sound whoring can be in games that aren't first-person shooters. Still useful.
Yay.
Better be, though. These were pretty expensive headsets. Or a expensive headset, kind of. Well, actually, they're bad expensive. What do these ballista do? Besides kill everything in the place. I guess it just kills everything in the place. Except for it doesn't kill everything in the place. It seems to miss everything. Because there were enemies like right in front of it and it just didn't do anything. Let's see. How much you guys want to bet? That's going to be a mimic. I was right! There we go. Mimics suck, but they drop lots of stuff. So they make up for it. Ballista. Fire the catapults, I missed. Better I just didn't. I don't even know. I should probably look up what the ballista do. I'll do that after I finish recording this. Probably a case of too little, too late, and another mimic. I didn't call that one. You win this one, game. You win this one. And only this one. Proceed, nothing over there. Wait, can I click on that table and get stuff? I can't click on that table and get stuff. Oh well. Bam! Massive one shot. Pet. Inventory management. That's pretty good. Plus 6 dexterity. Yeah. I don't want to sell that gem though. What's up? I'm gonna send my pet to town after I finish this level. If I can just sit here and wait and not have to get into battle and be in trouble when I don't have backup. Okay, so those guys steal mana, but they don't apparently do anything with it. Because I remember I was just playing Paper Mario 1000 Year Door before playing this. And I really hate the pink fuzzies because they use like the pink fuzzies. If you don't know what they do, they get like, they will take your flower points instead of your health, but they use it to like do this massive lightning attack that actually does pretty good damage compared to what they normally would do. Ooh, mysterious shoulders. But can they outdo the kind I already have? So that's kind of, ooh, that looks scary. Yep, that most definitely outdoes what I have now. Transmuter mantle. It doesn't have a model. Must be from that one mod that I had, or that I do have, where it takes the stuff and, like, takes stuff that was cut from the game and adds it back in. But apparently that was just a idea, and they had an equip icon for it, and so they made equipment out of that equip icon. Pretty intuitive for modders. Goblin Kidney Spike. Wait a minute, when did my pet be able to summon two of them? I've seen that, but they're summoned two minions. They're candy. I'm starting to think I'm freaking myself out of enough. No. Bad Deathwalker Battlemaster thingy. You do not anger the other enemies. My pack is full, but I can sense, I think the exit is just up ahead. Which is good, because I'm getting tired of how many enemies there are on just this floor. Ooh, critical hit, 2,000. Yes. Okay, money. I'm like so rich right now because I never buy anything because I always get good loot. Nothing? Oh, enemy. Oh, God. He came out of nowhere. Or I guess he came out of somewhere. He came out the wall. See, look at that. I'm sitting there blocking chain gun strikes thanks to block and parry. This is why we put points into things even if they don't seem like they're that useful first. Or at first. I find irony in this.
My inventory is full.
Your pet.
The enemies who steal mana, I just spam mana attacks and whoa. Skeleton attack.
When are they going to learn that you do not mess with a guy with a dragon helmet on his face and...
Aha, so my pet can summon two minions, I see. I'm not going crazy.
so many enemies. Where's the exit? I just want out of this madhouse. So there's an area up there, but I just guess I can't get to it. Critical hit for 2600 damage. Can I have that as normal attack speed? That would be so amazingly overpowered. But in single player, I don't care about overpowered. It's only when it's multiplayer. Kinzansarith the Grievous. Hold up, he can't move that fast. And he apparently seems to be just derping. Undead resist poison. Oh, he's like in that pile there. How come they can walk through the trash pile but I can't? I've lit him on fire.
My pack is full.
Pack is full. I'll just get out of here. What? The champion came out of the wall. Killed the construct. Killed the mechanical construct. Okay. So bows don't have that good of range, apparently. Damage, so I can still heal it back really fast.
Just beat him to death.
Pack is full. Leaving loot behind, I don't like doing that, but... Whoa, his bullets ricochet. I did not notice that. Learning so much in such a short time. This is going to be a very interesting tile set, isn't it? I deny you, enemies. Okay, so that's unnecessary. There was something here.
My track is full.
Money, money, money. Kill all the enemies. How did that one remain there after I walked through? They're not supposed to be left alive after I go through an area. Please tell me the exit's like right here. Sword dragging on, and I'm getting bored. And when I get bored, we have problems. Because when you get bored, you just stop watching. When I get bored, I can't really do anything because I still have to finish the series. So you can work on it. There we go. Mana spam. Spam. Special attack. What is this? That looks like the thing from Skyward Sword that you use to access Lanaru Mining Facility. That's a trap. Not falling for the trap. Not falling for the trap. Kill the mechanical construct. Lancing blow. You can't beat my armor. That's funny. Enemies everywhere. I hate those small and fast enemies. I found the stairs, yes! Took me long enough. So this has been Gently One. I will see you next time as we continue our adventures through the Dwarven Forge or whatever this place is.